Boom. What a load of bollocks, eh? All right, let's see if we can actually get a lap in now. Christ. Tires are blue. Likely to only get two laps in. Somehow still not lost. Pretty much missed the whole of quali. Trying to figure out why we can't get the stream going. But four fails, we'll just record. Sherman Tinsky up in 24th. Bit of a reference, I guess.
Car on the right.
Alright, we've got a bit of space now. Let's see if we can get some sort of lap in. We should be able to get a second lap.
Yellow flag in sector one.
Lost the back end just a little. Lost.
slow car up ahead. Yellow flag in sector 1. Yellow flag ahead, watch out.
A lot of water spin on the exit there.
Yellow flag, be careful there.
Can't believe the stream bugged out today, man. Unbelievable. Improvement.
Yellow flag, be careful. Session is now
32nd. When you've got to get 2 runs in, but I mean, that's pretty much all we could do, man. Pretty much all we could do. Wasted a bunch of time trying to get the stream working, but as I said, it just didn't work. Just didn't work. Cassini does a 57.9. Oh, it's crazy, man. Crazy time. But we'll see how it goes. Definitely seems to be a Mercedes fest up front, although Nils is doing a pretty good job in a BMW. Wow, 57.9, man. It's pretty damn crazy, to be honest. 39.3 in the first sector by Dowking, actually the fastest first sector. Dowking the first of the Ferraris. Brenner in 12th. Jim and Tinsky and Golter actually doing a pretty good job. 59.3, 59.4. Definitely could have jumped up a little bit further, I think, if I'd have just had a bit more time. But I'm actually going to go to the toilet, then I'll be back. Hold it. Hopefully the race pace is decent, man.
20 seconds.
Let's see, let's see.
10 seconds.
In the drive. Not expecting much from this race. It's going to be much more about strategy, I think, for myself. See what we can do there. We're starting on the left-hand side of the grid, which is not the best, man. I probably would have been better off starting 33rd, because I would have the inside. And when you're on the outside, it's very easy to get sort of pushed aside, and you're on the dirty side, and you just can't get the grip, so... But let's see what happens. Check everything over. Not too sure about the fuel. So we run engine map 8. Remember, maybe I should start on traction on 2, especially traction on 3, sorry, if the tires is blue, maybe. But we shall see. Oops, let me fix my light where it falls down. Shit. Definitely to get our tires warm, man. This is a low grip surface. It's Suzuka. Juice was needed.
Stay double fire.
Need to remember let's put our engine map back to 1 before we forget. Managed to get a bit of heat into the tires. Right, this has got to be, as you can probably tell by Goltor's position, one of the worst tracks for the Bentley. Doesn't seem to have a lot going for it around here. I thought it would be really good through sort of the first sector, but surprisingly, it's got a crap BOP around here. I don't know why. I thought Monza was bad.
Green light. Go, go, go. Car on the right. Clear on the right. Car on the right.
Try and keep it tight.
Clear on the right. Car on the right. Clear on the right. Car on the right.
Seconds, just like that. Fucking hell.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
Yep, there goes that damage. We're going to see how bad this damage is once we turn in here. A lot of people pitting straight away. Oh god, the understairs. Ridiculous. Now you guys understand why I did not want to start on the outside. You're pretty much stuck on the outside until it goes to single file, you know? Now the handling is absolutely horrendous. Absolutely horrendous, man. Already a sitting duck down the straight, so could only imagine. It's not gonna get much better. I think we're gonna have to pit soon.
Well done, mate. The fastest step so far.
Oh. Well, the car just doesn't want to turn at all. I'm not sure where that damage is, whether it's front or rear, but... seems to have a lot of understeer. Look how much time we're losing on the straight. We're losing absolute tons on the straight, man. Insane. I don't think we have a choice, we have to fix the damage. We're keeping up with the pack, but nothing else really. I think the guy in the Audi behind was quite a lot quicker, so he must have got caught up at the beginning. Not gonna fire too hard. Try and lose as least amount of time as possible before I got coming to the pits. The damage just actually feels like it's getting worse. I think I should probably pit this lap. I should just pit this lap. It's much earlier than what I wanted to pit. I'm even struggling just to get the car turned around, you know?
Car on the right. car on the left. Clear on the left.
Just get this damage fixed because it's just gonna annoy me, to be honest. I haven't quite sure what happened, man, at the beginning. Very nice second pit stop, man. Unbelievable. You know what you see, we're going to lose all these positions. I want to see who it was who actually smashed into the car. We'll be lucky if we're not getting lapped straight away, which would mean we'd have to get out of the way of a ton of other people as well. Nightmare, man. Absolute nightmare. Somehow not dead last.
Yellow flag in sector 3.
We definitely need to start putting in the lap times, but again, also need to make sure we don't kill our tires straight away, you know? Asini looks like he's got a 4-second lead already. Crazy. Let's see if we can catch Aid. I'm trying to squeeze the brake so gently. Trying to make sure I have some tire left at the end. I've got some good news and some bad news. I'm catching aid. Is the good news. The bad news is Southall's catching me. Oh, Christ. Can't get it slowed down now. Wonderful. He's doing 2 minute laps at the minute.
Well done, mate. This is me, your Russell Vest.
Goto has a 15 second penalty. What if it was Goto to hit us? Oh, we finally made the last corner. Much better lap from Aid this time.
Well done, mate. Personal fastest lap.
One of Aid is saving fuel. You know, the Ferrari eats quite a lot of fuel these days. Okay, someone's got to stop and go. I'm sure that'll put us ahead of somebody.
Gaining on the driver ahead in sector 3.
It's going to be interesting to see how the tires fare. Definitely getting closer to aid now. My pace is pretty consistent at the minute.
There's a car leaving the pit lane, watch out.
Hey, we jumped somebody. Goals, I think that was. Already you can start to feel the fronts going.
Yellow flag ahead, watch out in front.
Something's happened up ahead.
There's a slow car up ahead.
Someone's off. Struggling big time on brakes right now. My brake bias a little bit more rear, which I think.
Gaining on the car ahead is up to 3.
Awful lap.
The car is exiting the pits, watch out.
Goals has fully caught me now. Castelli up ahead.
left. Clear on the left. Car on the right. Clear on the right. Car on the left.
Wow, look at the straight line speed difference.
Clear on the left.
Wow, this is awful, BOP, this. That is awful. Drive free for somebody. I literally have no straight line speed to fight with. Still can't quite get slowed down for that corner. Okay, the guy that had the drive-through was already behind us. Goals is flying. Literally, when it comes to grip in the first sector, death. So I imagine Cadillac and Southall will be on our rear bumper pretty soon. Ideally, I wanted to pit with around 40 minutes to go. This has literally become a battle for last place. Really struggling in that last chicane in a minute.
There's a car exiting mid lane. Losing time to the car in front in sector 3. Car on the right. Clear on the right. Car on the right.
Oops.
Clear on the right.
Tires are under pressure as well. Oh, it's all gone wrong today, lads. It's all gone wrong. Second penalty for car 78, car 447. Not that it matters, they're well down the road to me. Somehow gained a position. Drive through for car 105. Oh. A lot of these penalties seem like they're coming for cars that's already behind us, so. On the outside.
Yellow flag ahead, watch out.
Another yellow flag, what?
There's a slow car up ahead.
Okay, drive through for, it's like two cars ahead. Or at least one penalty.
I'm
not bothering to fight anyone with the fresher tires, it's pointless. Just gonna end up wearing my own tires even more. So, we're pretty much gonna cruise it to the end. This race has been a disaster. My front tires have completely disappeared. Christ. I can no longer actually slow the car down. That's how bad the tires are in a minute. Watts, who is 3.5 seconds behind me, has a 15 second penalty. Goto has a 15 second penalty as well. What's going on? What's going on, mate? Actually have to short shift up into fourth pretty early there. Bentley's still getting wheel spin up in third gear. Not a lot of front end left in this car. Yeah, I knew the tyres would be quite a bit of a struggle. So that's unfortunate I had to pit so early, man. It makes sense for me to try and hold up Watts a little bit, as he does have a 15 second penalty, so if he does catch us, we'll try and stay in front of him. Oh god. Wow, the tyres have gone. 17 minutes to go and our tyres have actually shit the bed. Oh, they're definitely gone. Gonna have to start taking that in third gear now. This has definitely not been a great race so far. But, hey ho. I have to say though, I am actually pretty disappointed with Kunos in terms of their BOP for the Bentley round here, man. It's actually awful. It's terrible. By the way it looks, I'm not going to have to worry about whether he's going to get past or not. I'm going to have to worry about more whether he's not going to run straight into the back of me, because you've got so much more speed. And in terms of tyres, I literally have nothing left to give. We had initial pace when we came out of the pits, but it did not last long at all, man. Wow.
left. Clear on the left. Car on the right. Clear on the right. Car on the left. Clear on the left.
It's just got the much fresher tires, man. There's not much I can do. It'd be so much quicker, even through the S's, you know? Drive through for car 447, don't know who that is. I'm sure it won't affect our race too much. Just try and stay within 15 seconds to Watts. The first two tracks on this calendar would be pretty bad for the Bentley, but I still like the car. But for me, I have to say on this game now at the moment, I just don't think they've got the BOP right for this car. For me, just judging by what I see in real life, the Bentley seems to be pretty handy in a straight line whenever I watch it in real life. In this game, it's just got, it's nothing. There's nothing in a straight line. Kennedy's ended up behind us somehow. People all around with penalties, man. What's going on? Also, he was the person who got the drive-through. Right, right. Okay. The drive-through and 15 seconds? Ooh, that's steep. That is definitely steep, man. More penalties coming in. Obviously, live stupids this season, AOR.
relative to the car ahead in sector one.
Losing a lot of time to Watts. Next track is actually Hungaroring. Which I expect the car to be a little bit more competitive, but that race will be wet. So we're going to have to get the car sorted for them conditions. Massive freeze right there. Minutes to go, about three laps. Actually, when Hassini comes around, we only have two laps. Wow, I cannot believe how bad the tires are right now, man. Gone completely and utterly. Luckily for us, Watts has got traffic. Maybe if these guys start battling up ahead, doesn't really make much sense to, but if they do, maybe they can lose a bit of time, I don't know. Christ. We've clearly also taken way too much fuel. Three of the H3 guys all retired. Wow.
Yellow flag in sector 2. Right, man. Leader is on the final lap. Give it all you can.
Cassini looking like he's absolutely destroyed it again. Wonko actually behind us. I wonder what happened to Wonko.
Slow car ahead.
Alright, last lap, lads. Oh, my suspension is terrible. Absolutely bouncing off of that curb. I believe we gained another place, I think. So it definitely wasn't because of pace.
Neither has finished the race.
I think we're getting a lot of lagging towards the end of this race. We'll gain that last position, well, we'll gain that one more position off of Watts.
get back to the pits.
Okay, well, that was it, lads. It was very sad race. Oh, what is going on here? Game seems to have frozen. All right, that's what was going on. Turn to pits, maybe? Right. We have a look at the replay, man. I've gone past it. Let's see what happens here. Oh! Okay, I see what happens. Gold Tours rear-ended the McLaren. The McLaren has shot itself into me. Bit of a nightmare, I guess. Cadillac? It was Cadillac. Gold. Gold Tour. Okay, let's quickly see what happens. Oh, whoa. It also gets put round. That's crazy, man. Trying to get back on track cleanly. Oh, and then it just... probably just gathering his surroundings again. Just nudges the McLaren. Pops the curb. Oh, Christ. It was messy. It was messy. I'm actually not going to put too much blame on Goldstore there because a lot was going on at the same time, you know? And definitely wasn't Cadillac's fault. Who was it in? Sorry. Wonders. Who have we got? An aid. Was that Ferrari?
Green light, give it all you can.
Let's just go back, guys, and quickly do this. Again, I'm very, very sorry I couldn't bring the stream to you guys live because I don't know what's going on with it. This is just currently uploading a video. I don't know if that has anything to do with it, but keep bollocks. Anyway. Let's try and get exactly what happened. Right, so we need to go back. Hold. Steady, right? Focus. Also got binned before that. Yes, I think it's this guy. He did try to avoid it, to be honest. You know, it's I think it's one of those. I don't think it's not like a dirty move where he was trying to get up the inside. He's just had to get out of the throttle at the last minute, you know? I mean, it's clumsy. It's clumsy at worst, you know? Oh, look at that. Everyone getting killed. I want to have a little look at actually the start, right? At my start. I was actually trying to be as clean as I possibly could, but a lot of the time, the same thing could have happened to me to the McLaren in front, because he wasn't defending me, but he was kind of cutting across the line, not knowing what line he was going to take. You can see he's a little bit all over the place, you know? We didn't go, did we go far enough back? Go far enough. Let's get, when we're coming out of turn, basically turn one. See, he covers the line, kind of. And this is where the craziness goes on. I try and stick to the outside here so I can get the inside. But you can see like when you're having to press the brakes, especially when the car is like loaded up going through certain corners, it actually makes it so sketchy. It's very hard to explain, man. It's like, it's pretty easy to press the brakes in a place, like it's pretty easy to lose the back end when you're pressing the brakes in a place that you'd never be braking hard, you know. So I managed to get away with that. It all got pretty tight around here. I did let off. I did intentionally. I didn't really even know if there's a car on the inside, but I intentionally left the door open just so, you know, I'm not trying to get into a massive scrap on the first lap of the race. Stayed wide on purpose. I did everything I could do, man. I tried. I did everything I could do. I stayed out of trouble. I stayed wide. But, like, there's nothing I can do to that, man. I even stayed wide here just to make sure. But of course, obviously the damage is already done. And yeah, I started to feel the damage pretty much instantly, man. The cornering performance was just not there. But yeah. We must have lost a bit of straight line as well, but I mean, it is what it is, man. But what else was there? There wasn't really much else that happened, was there? And goals probably had a little bit of a nice battle through the yeah, let's go to this battle with goals. And let's see. Now we could, let's see the straight line difference. Like, bearing in mind I was running quite a lot of wing, right? But if I put the wing to zero, I'm not going to make it around the rest of the circuit, so. Keeps his nose in, which is brave. I'll give him the space. And we actually went side by side for this next section. Now here, I actually get a better run out of the corner. I do hit the curb a little bit, but I've got like the inside line, which is shorter. Watch the straight line speed difference, bro. Look at that. He's able to pull completely clear. Like, that's crazy to me, man. Crazy. Especially as in real life, you know, from whenever I've watched SRO, the Bentley, one of the Bentley strengths seems to be its straight line speed. So I'm not quite sure where the straight line speed is for the Bentley on this game. I don't know. At the end of the day, that we are currently on the 2020 sort of patch or for the 2020 season, and I don't know, like, I just feel like they're just touching the cars that they want to touch, like they're only touching the cars that are, I've got hype build around them, because, you know, like the Ferrari Evo is new, the AMG Evo is new, but honestly the Ferrari Evo in real life doesn't do fuck all. Do you know what I mean? On this on this game, they've made it such a beast, you know, that it's just quick everywhere. But in real life, the Ferrari Evo is not really doing anything. So, I don't know, man. I mean, I watched the Lexus and the Bentley around Misano, and they were flying. Absolutely flying. And this game is just, you know, the Bentley is just, it's a nice car to drive, but it's not the fastest anywhere. It's not even one of the fastest anywhere. So, it's pretty sad. You even say, like, the Audi in real life is, I don't remember if they won the championship, but I remember they were damn quick. This season just gone. I would expect the Audi to still be up there, but I feel like whenever like a new car comes out, I just feel like just focus on giving the new car its shine, its moment in the sun, you know what I mean? Instead of keeping it to how it is in real life. But I guess that's the path they've chosen, bro. It's what it is. But guys, I'm gonna get off, man. Thanks for watching the video, and yeah, Cryptic TMG, and I will catch you guys next time. Hopefully the stream works next time, but for this time, obviously, bollocks. But yeah, I'll catch you guys in a bit, man. Peace.